Hello everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I have another very important topic, and I get this question often. I hear it a lot of times. I'm asked a lot of times by many people on LinkedIn, Instagram, and on YouTube comments. Of course, people do ask me that, how did I manage to run my own firm? How did I start my own business? What exactly are the pros and cons of running your own firm in a foreign land? And I thought there is no one answer to this particular question. So I do realize that I need to make a special vlog on this. So here I am. Today I'm going to discuss how I started my own thing, and what do you have to keep in mind, what the factors that you have to keep in mind, and how it was an experience for me and how it is still is, right? So basically today I'm going to let you know some tips and tricks that I have followed in my own practice, and I'm not going to discuss a typical day in what my life is, because that's the mainstream thing. I'm going to discuss some details that I have resonated from a lot of experience till now. And let's begin by telling you one thing that I do realize. I've worked in law firms in India. I have had good internship experiences. I've had good exposure to that kind of corporate field, corporate law, all kind of fields, right? Plus litigation. So I do realize that when you have to run your own law firm, you are basically not just going to be a good lawyer. Being good lawyer is one thing. Yes, you have to ace your practice, but you also have to be a very good entrepreneur. So I often tell people that it's not very easy to run your own law firm. No matter how easy it looks, it's not that simple. And specifically when you are in a foreign land, when you have to make local contacts, when you have to go through that networking zone and all of that. But now when I have crossed that bridge and I am learning day to day, I do want to share my experience with all of you, so that when any of you, and all of you are here, and most of you are here or whatsoever, but as in when you are here, you do get there some helpful things, and it does help you through. One of the most important thing in Canada, what I have seen as an internationally trained lawyer and going through my practice and resources here since the time I've been into practice, is that a lot of people who come out of this licensing process, who as soon as they get their bar licenses, they do tend to start their own practice. People do realize that one thing is that the much paying your self-employed practices, you won't probably get in an initial job, and people have to run their families, and you know, they have a lot of responsibility on their head. So there are few types of practices in Canada that anybody can tap on, because it's easy and it's quick money. And you can't just say it's easy to get business in that, and that one business is real estate, which a lot of lawyers you would be seeing are doing. Because what happens in Canada is that any kind of property that you buy or sell has to go through a real estate agent, and further through a lawyer. So the closing of your deal would be through a lawyer. So when lawyers do that, they usually charge, say, about this, now this start from anywhere around 800 to 1200, depending on what residential commercial property it is. So $800 or $1200. So basically, the many lawyers, they, I have heard that they do around 100 closings a month. So that's like good money for them, and it's more rewarding than a job. So hats off to those people who start off their own practice, just because, you know, I do understand that they do have to do a lot of responsibility on their head and have to take care of it. But what I do realize specifically for my case was that I was not interested in this area of practice, and I was keenly working towards. I initially started with a refugee matter, and then that's how I was working in a law firm, and that's how I realized that no, I can actually pick up my own work, have with the hands-on experience, and start with this. Plus, it really depends on your kind of family support that you get. My partner was very supportive. In fact, he's one of the business partners in our firm, and the other person is Shahrukh. As you all might know, that Shahrukh is also a dear friend and a business partner, so we've all been really like very go-to, and it was just for the moment. So we started our own ACE law practice, and ACE law is, by the way, doing a lot of business migration cases, and hence that is my key area of interest. I do like to read about Investment Act, and I go through all of that in day-to-day routine. So basically now I did not want to specialize. We all do diversify, but now by the time when your practice gets old, you do try to tend to focus to a particular area initially, and we still do a lot of criminal matters, we do civil matters, and matters do come to you. See, there's no, it's not that you are, you know, you will not find work. When you actually want to find work, somehow the work will also find you. So it has never been a day where I have, you know, thought that why did I start my own thing. I have always embraced the feeling of starting my own firm. Now, few of the factors that I want you guys to consider before, once you get your licensing and have gone through that process, is first, how can you sustain? How risk averse are you? Now, risk aversion say I do not mean ki aapke paas कितने फाइनेंसेस है. ऑफ कोर्स फाइनेंसेस इज वन क्राइटेरिया टू इट. सेकंड इज कि आप हाउ मच आर यू विलिंग टू गिव. Are you a person who's like, you know, a 9-to-5 person? Then this is not for you. Are you a person who's like shy and timid and can't talk much to people, do not like to, you know, go out of your zone, out of your box, get in touch with everybody, and you know, you are just very comfortable in your comfort box? Then this is not for you. You have to, again, another thing is calculate that how much confidence basically you have in yourself. Are you confident enough? Do you think, yes, out there in the world, you have already had experience in a common law country like India, Pakistan, you know, wherever you can think as a common law country, wherever you are coming from, do you think that you can basically, you know, make your local resources? Then if your heart says yes, then do follow this thing. Do follow your heart, because you know, if sometimes your brain will tell you something, but what your heart says, you need to follow that, and believe you me, that is the key to success. It is just a minor difference on where you have to select your head and heart. So a combination of both is ideally what I go for. Sometimes I think from my heart, sometimes I think from my brain, and usually both situations in collaboration work very well for me. Now, the other point that I do want to discuss is that how is your business sense? Do you think you can handle, because at some time you won't have employees with you when you start, right? Because you have a limited budget, you have limited kind of resources. Now, you do want to emphasize on your business skills. Now, some people are not meant for business. They know that they can't do business, because a law practice is not only doing some kind of paperwork that is going to come to you. How is that paper going to come to you? How is the client going to come to you? How are you going to manage client expectations? How are you going to keep accounting into record? How are you going to maintain law society rules and ethics? How are you going to be, you know, in so much of things that go together? Can you manage it all? Do you have the business sense? And the most important thing is, can you get business? So it's very important to keep your clients happy, to, you know, no, it's a service industry. So basically it's so competitive that you actually have to have good services. Now, if you are good in something, then automatically from one client, you'll get another client. From another, you will get a third one. It's like word of mouth till date. No matter how much you socialize, how much you are on social media, how much you market yourself, it does not matter. What matters in the end is how good you are with what you do, along with a very good blend of being a very good business person. How you don't have to sell yourself. Never sell yourself, and never even short sell yourself. Do not, I think in my career till now, what I've realized is that the services I offer as a lawyer can be maybe they're available in the market with a less legal fee. But I know when I do it with all my heart, and my client's file, maybe if it's just a small investment for him, but it's like everything for me that I do. It's I do understand that some people have their all savings into this, and I do realize, and emotionally, you know, that emotional quotient is there in me, and I do realize that I have to take care of it. So even if my face is there, it's just because if I value you, you value my time. So basically, importance of time, and I do not like to short sell myself ever. Then the third thing I like to talk about is your experience. Now, I would not recommend anybody to start their own practice as they are just, you know, fresh law graduates, cleared, gone through the NCA process, everything, and they became lawyers in Canada, and you obviously have an immigration status. So I would not recommend anybody without zero experience to start. इट इज नॉट समथिंग दैट आई से कि 10 10 साल का आपको एक्सपीरियंस चाहिए स्टार्ट करने के लिए. आई डोंट, आई एम नॉट ऑफ दैट स्कूल ऑफ थॉट. आई ऑल्सो थिंक दैट यंग पीपल, यंग एंटरप्रेन्योर, सो मच पीपल अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड आर डूइंग सो मच. यंग यंग किड्स आर डूइंग सो मच, दे हैव देयर ओन स्टार्टअप्स एंड एवरीथिंग. एंड आफ्टर ऑल अ लॉ फर्म इज ऑल्सो बेसिकली योर ओन स्टार्टअप, राइट? सो आई डो नॉट थिंक दैट यू नीड अ लॉट ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस फॉर दिस, बट यू डू नीड अ डिसेंट एक्सपीरियंस टू नो हाउ विल यू एक्चुअली वर्क, हाउ इज योर टेम्परमेंट with your work. So how can you, you know, deal with a particular situation? You sometimes you might just lose, and you will not just lose, it's after all a loss for yourself as well, but it's a major loss for your client. So sometimes a lot of things are at stake, and you have to be very careful with all that. You have to be very diligent with all of that. So basically, I do not say a much diverse experience, like 5 to 10 years, but I do say a decent 2 to 3 years of experience. And I, when I say 2 to 3 years experience, I do count myself saying that your internships included in that. Why? Because your internships, I know how much we work hard in our internships in India. At least I have. So basically, I'm taking somebody on as an intern in my firm, I do realize that I will not put them for free on work. So the people actually, they get very much motivated. And I think in lawyers and in this field, we do need to motivate each other. So even if you think you have a little bit of experience, but you have the confidence, you have the risk aversion, you have the business sense, then do not even give it a second thought, according to me. The next thing I think I want to talk about with you guys is that how law is a tool to you with you, which you can help people. You know, when I came to Canada, I had no such thing in my mind that I will open my own thing. But as a tool that can help people, I started helping people with small immigration matters, because it was, for me, it was just reading the law and helping them out with their matters. I did tend to help a lot of people in that time when I was studying and going through my process. And that is when I realized that, okay, no matter where in the world you are, even in India, even in Canada, I do realize the fact that no matter where in the world you are, one tool in your hand is your education and your degree and this particular thing called law in your hand. So basically, when you do understand something, you can't even imagine the kind of small reading and researching and help we can do for somebody that layperson is not aware of, that layman is not aware of. So basically, this is like a very powerful tool that we have to use it, and we should know how to use it, right? We should know where we can make money and where we should not make money, where we should be more compassionate towards people, and where we should know that, okay, this is now more of my time and this has to be valued, this has to be compensated. And basically, that is where your own business sense come in. Do not be very greedy. Start, just, you know, don't be out of the box and making, just wanting to make huge money with few cases. No, it's over a period of time in your practice that you realize that as a self-employed person, as somebody who has to in the end be directly accountable to the clients, just be very reasonable and be very ethical with your clients, even in Canada, even in India, wherever. Now, I do have clients from overseas, obviously, because I do immigration. But even when I have local clients, I do tend to report them everything that's happening with their case. Or maybe I make it a habit to say once in 2 weeks, but I do try to. It's always on my mind. And when you can do multitasking, do a lot of things, then this thing, I'm sure, running your own law firm, you too can manage. If you have partners, that's well and good, because you tend to diversify more, you tend to share responsibility more. At the same time, one of you has to be the managing partner. Why? Because you need to manage small nitty-gritties of the office, which you don't realize right now. But when you open your own firm, then there is everything that you have to look into, from the photocopy to basically even, you know, filing things. So everything in an office in Ontario, I have realized here in Canada, that we can do everything and anything. It's like we are very smart. We just need to be very confident about our own selves, have a little kind of risk aversion. Everybody will flourish, even if the job market is down, but still your own practice will इट्स योर ओन राइट. सो आपको पता है आप उसमें कितना काम ला सकते हो, आप एंड ऑफ द डे आपकी कैपेबिलिटी पे है. अब मैंने कई लोग ऐसे भी देखे हैं जो यहाँ के बॉर्न हैं बट उनसे अपनी प्रैक्टिस नहीं रन हुई. सो हाउ इज दैट पॉसिबल? इट्स जस्ट बेसिकली द डिफरेंस ऑफ एटीट्यूड. हाउ मच इंडिपेंडेंट एज यू आर एज अ पर्सन, हाउ मच यू नो आई एम लाइक नॉट अ 9 to 5 पर्सन. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू वर्क एट नाइट आई कैन वर्क एट नाइट, इफ आई वॉन्ट टू वर्क एट डे आई विल वर्क एट डे. सो नो बडी दैट मोनोटोनी I just can't tolerate. So that's with me, but that's not a very good thing though. But that is there, so I can't help it. तो मेरे को पता था मेरा temperament कैसा है, तो मैंने उस temperament के हिसाब से अपनी situation में adjust करा, right? And by God's grace, all is well that way. But I just, my quick suggestion is that start from whatever you have and do whatever you can, right? Basically, just try to spread that kind of positivity, and I am sure the universe will make things happen the way you want them to happen. But just work towards it. The universe is not just going to come to you and, you know, make it happen. So that's me for today. And if you want to go check out my website and everything in my about me, then I do share the link of my website in the description box. And if you want me to vlog about anything specifically related to other than starting your own practice in Canada and how are the things related to that, so you can do put in the comment section. And thank you so much. Bye bye, take care, good night.